I'm now planning to discuss with you about the power spectrum, and it has an interesting relation to the autocorrelation function. The autocorrelation function you may already know about. It is a measure of the statistical dependency of a signal and its time-shifted copy. And then you are using different time difference between this shift. The power spectrum can be interpreted as how the signal power is distributed onto different frequencies. But let us start with a review of the autocorrelation function. And as I said, it is a statistical measure of the dependency between a signal and its time-shifted copy. And for an analog energy signal, it is defined as the integral of x of t multiplied with x of t plus tau, where tau is then the time shift between those two copies. And we are integrating over the time from minus infinity to infinity in order to analyze the correlation between those two copies. And for an analog periodic power signal, it is defined as in a similar way, product of xt plus times multiplied with xt plus tau. And now we are integrating over the period of this periodic signal from 0 to t, and we are dividing with the period of t. We have similar definitions for time discrete energy signals, but now we have the k for the definition of number of samples as the difference between the shifted copies. And we are using n as the number of samples for the period. If a stochastic process is known, then the autocorrelation function can alternatively be defined as, for the analog power signal, as the expected value of two stochastic variables. That comes from the fact that when we are fixing the time for a stochastic process, what we get is a stochastic variable. And two of those are x of t and x of t plus tau, where tau is then the time shift between the time points when we are fixing the stochastic process. And we are computing the expected value. For a time discrete power signal, we have the similar definition, except that now we have k that is defining the difference in number of samples, the expected value of x of n times x of n plus k. And for the autocorrelation function, if tau is equal to 0, meaning that there is no time difference between the points that we analyze, then the autocorrelation function will be equal to the expected value of x of t multiplied with x of t. And this is the expected value of x squared, which we know as the total mean power. And this is equal to the variance of x plus the mean value in square. The autocorrelation function for tau equal to 0 is proportional to and is defined as the total mean power for the signal. This because of that we can analyze the autocorrelation function for tau equal to 0 for this power signal. 0 to t, which where t is the period of the power signal, and we are dividing with t, and we are integrating xt multiplied with xt plus 0, meaning xt squared. And we can recognize this as the power integral. Now, the power spectrum of a signal actually is the frequency transformed by Fourier computed on the autocorrelation function. And the power spectrum, as I said to you before, show how a signal's power is distributed onto different frequencies. And then I will go directly to an example, which is the white noise that we have been talking about. The autocorrelation of white noise is the delta function. And the reason that it becomes a delta function is due to the fact that for white noise, adjacent samples in time are completely uncorrelated. So the the autocorrelation function of a signal that is represented by white noise is equal to the delta function. And then, as I said, the power spectrum, which is denoted like this, x of omega, which is the frequency transform of x of omega in square, is equal to the Fourier transform, the frequency transform of the autocorrelation function. And this is equal to 1, because the frequency transform of the delta function is equal to 1. And this has some interesting opportunities to analyze this white noise, because if the frequency transform of the white noise is equal to 1, a constant 1, that means that the white noise then contains equal amount of power of all frequencies, all possible frequencies. This is illustrated here in this graph, where we have the autocorrelation function of white noise, this delta spike, and then we apply the frequency transform by Fourier on this delta spike, and we have a constant of 1 on the power spectrum, which means that all powers have equal amount of power, all frequencies have equal amount of power. Since we know that for any kind of signal processing system, the bandwidth cannot be like completely unlimited, there must be always some kind of limit. So if we start from this white noise model, then it can be interesting to know what happens with the autocorrelation function if we actually limit the bandwidth instead of having like infinite bandwidth. So what we see here on this picture is a power spectrum where we have limit the bandwidth of this previous white noise to omega g. So whenever the frequencies are higher or higher than omega g or minus omega g, then the value of the power spectrum is equal to 0. And now we are going to apply the inverse frequency transform, which is the inverse Fourier frequency transform on this power spectrum, to analyze how will the corresponding autocorrelation function look like. And I'm not going into the details of the computation of the inverse Fourier transform integral, but it will be a sinc function, omega g divided by p multiplied with the sinc function of omega g tau. And you know how the sinc function look like. We have this main lobe, and then the amplitude of this waveform will decrease as we reach infinity or minus infinity. And this sinc function then is defined as sine of A divided by A. We know that the delta function of white noise, signal's autocorrelation function, will now turn into the main lobe of a sinc function if we apply low-pass filtering on white noise. In this case, we have an ideal low-pass filter, but it will be the same even if you have, or similar if you are using any kind of other kinds of characteristics of a low-pass filter. Noise in real-world measurement systems is always bandwidth limited, and thus it will be seen more as a sinc function rather than the delta function when we apply or compute the autocorrelation function. And I think now it's time to sum up this video presentation by drawing a number of conclusions on both autocorrelation function as well as power spectrum. The power spectrum can be interpreted as how the signal power is distributed onto different frequencies. And secondly, the autocorrelation function can be interpreted as how strong the adjacent measurement samples correlate to each other. And the power spectrum can be computed as the Fourier transform of the autocorrelation function. And equally, the autocorrelation function can be computed as the reverse Fourier transform of the power spectrum. The mean power of the signal computed from its power spectrum RF equals the integration of the power spectrum RF over the frequency domain from minus infinity to infinity. and the mean power of the signal computed from its autocorrelation function equals the correlation autocorrelation function for tau equal to zero.